Yeah. So we have left with the human environment. I'll just open your book now. Let me see. 104. Let me see till where I have explained. Evolution of human beings, human environment interaction, ecosystem we have done. Yes, only human environment is left. Okay. So human beings interact with the environment and modify it according to the needs I told you earlier. Now, early humans adapted themselves to the natural surroundings. They led a simple life and fulfilled their requirements from the natural surroundings around them. With time, needs grew and became more varied. Humans learned new ways to use and change the environment. Now what happened in the first part? They led to a simple life. Okay, early humans adapted themselves to the natural surroundings. Whatever was there, they were using it. What they had hunting, they hunted. They didn't have clothes, they were wearing skins. Then it changed, they wanted more needs. They started using stones for hunting, for cutting. And humans learned new ways to use and change environment. Brains got into them, they started thinking, they started using their brains. They started changing the environment. They learned to grow crops, domesticate animals, and lead a settled life. Then the wheel was invented. I've already done it in history with you. Surplus food was produced. Barter system emerged, means giving and taking without money. Okay. Then trade started. Commerce developed. Industrial revolution enabled large scale of production. Transportation became faster. Information technology revolution came in. That communication made it easy and speedy across the world for things to go around. Sometimes have you ever thought, just an example, why you love eating juicy watermelon in summer and hot roasted peanuts in winter? Why don't you eat hot roasted peanuts in summer? A perfect balance is necessary between the natural and human environment. Humans must learn to live and use their environment in a harmonious way, don't spoil it. Now if you go to Mizoram, if you go to Sikkim, if you go to Darjeeling, you see only greeneries. Fields and all, it's not being disturbed. People enjoy that life. They're trying to save it. And here we are only digging up play fields, we are bringing that, closing down farming areas, bringing up malls, factories, whatever we are doing, we are spoiling it. Isn't it? So this is all about it. And this can be, I've explained everything together one shot in a very easy way. And we are at 104, right? Each time I forget the page. I understand what is there in the book, and after that I go ahead. Evolution of human beings, I told you. Human environment interaction, in spite of all developments, the physical environment still provides human beings with their material needs. Farming, fishing, forestry, and mining provide food and raw materials without which advanced societies cannot survive and progress. Okay, human beings and their activities also represent the greatest danger to environment. Right from the dawn of human civilization, people have not only used nature for their existence. Okay, I'll read this for you. I gave my explanation, I'll give it from the book also. But also exploited and misused it to a certain extent. Thus, they have disturbed the natural balance of the environment. Okay. Environmental pollution. When the disturbance made by human beings in the environment are less, nature can easily repair and maintain it. But when the exploitation is on a large scale, nature fails to repair it. This creates a problem not only for nature but also for humans. Today the whole world is facing various problems due to technological and scientific development in one hand, and overpopulation, urbanization and industrialization on the other. Environment pollution is a result of unplanned and unwise use of technology. A perfect balance is needed between the natural and human environment. Now this pandemic happened. Simple example. Last year, when did you have monsoons? Last year you had monsoons in July. I remember because I came here on the 30th of June. Till 30th of June, you didn't have any rain. And after that, it started raining heavily in the month of July and August. Then you had floods. This year, it started exact on the 14th. Why? Everyone is at home. There was a lockdown. No pollution, no factories running, nothing running. The atmosphere had become clean. The air had become clean. So, environment was taking its own natural way to have it. See, we are still today, till today, we are having rains. Beautiful. Look at this weather. We didn't even understand when the heat passed by during this lockdown. Right? So we have to respect nature. We have to protect it. This is it. People from here could see Himalayan hills from Bihar. There was a write-up on the newspaper also, in the news also. People could see Darjeeling from our Bengal also, from the foothills. Atmosphere has become clear. It's become much more a better place. But all the time there is this cram, jam, smoke coming out, this, that, pollution. The atmosphere gets disturbed. Factories, you know. Then we have this overpopulation, too much of people, overpopulated places, cram jammed in one place. Urbanization is not perfect. Industries are coming up one after another. Unplanned use of technology. It is important that all of us understand and learn to live and use the environment in a harmonious way. Only then will a balance in nature be maintained. Just see this pandemic, it was so nice. I mean, the lockdown is bad, pandemic is really bad, the COVID-19, this disease is bad. But I am telling you about this atmosphere during this lockdown, it became so nice. See the weather now. You can see it for yourself. Exactly in June, do you actually have this time the Met office, the meteorological office said at 14 June it started. Monsoons came in. Exactly. Trees and plants are saved from the smoke, they are able to take in their food, they are able to bring in clouds, the actual evaporation is happening. You know, it's a wonderful place to live in. So environment has to be saved at any cost. Otherwise, in the coming future, we'll have a lot of problems. So this chapter is done and I will give you the notes and use all the study through. And when I send you the notes, it will be crystal clear. You'll be able to understand. You'll read the notes. What I told you is what is there in the notes. And solved question answers are there. Rest you will do for yourself. Okay. And next class, let me see if I am able to. I'll discuss the fill in the blanks and then take the right answers and all for you. And you can just hear my video and do it in your book, or on your you just mark it in your book, and after that you can write it down in your copies. Guys, please make sure you have your copies ready. I'm not saying you have to have a copy. Whatever you have arranged, however you have written it in fair or in rough, no issues. Because it's a lockdown, everyone is having problems getting things in a better way is to do it in a perfect way. I just want you to write it down and do the homework and keep it. Because when school opens, I'm going to just check it for you. And the rest all is solved. So please follow this and stay home, stay safe and do your writings also. Learn your spellings, do a lot of reading. This is the time you have, lot of time, so why don't you do that? And take care of yourselves and be home, be safe. God bless. See you in the next class on Friday. Bye bye. And do whatever you want after your studies.